the darkest grace. The sun bursts, clouds break. Yeah, we see that fire from the streets of Babylon.
Robinson was a leading figure that proved to the United States that any race could play professional sports without segregation. Starting in 1947, Branch Rickey, the manager of the Brooklyn Dodgers, allowed Jackie to play so long as he agreed not to react to any players, coaches, and umpires for being racist, such as having rude behaviors as spitting on his shoes. Jackie persevered such bad behaviors to prove he and other races could play sports just as well or even better than white players. By succeeding in baseball, Jackie broke the color barrier in sports, and after 1950, he began standing up for himself and transformed society's image for all black athletes.
Negro League Baseball was invented in 1920, and they continued until 1960, even though the color barrier was already broken. Negroes knew that something had to be done. At one point, the Negroes were planning on having an uprising in America for their own rights. Branch Rickey, former Dodgers owner, talked to players and staff about recruiting black players. Lots of them were opposed to the idea. They also thought recruiting black players would bring black fans and all the white fans would leave. Back in 1947, when Jackie Robinson joined the MLB, baseball was America's pastime, unlike today, where football is the main sport.
Baseball, which is called the national pastime, really isn't anymore. Football is. You know, the college and pro football really are the big sports for America now. Everybody watches the Super Bowl. Basketball and baseball are probably on a parallel, and even basketball is probably even more popular now. But back then, in the 1940s, baseball was the sport. And so for Jackie Robinson, even if he knew it was his weakest sport, that was the way you were going to make it.
Jackie Robinson inspired many during his time in the military. One time, he was sitting next to an African-American woman on a bus. The bus driver did not notice that she was an African-American woman, and he commanded Robinson to go to the back of the bus. Robinson refused, and he was later arrested. Jackie proved to the world that anyone could play, and play just as well as white players. For 3 years, he didn't react to any other person or fan being mean to him, though he could barely hold it in himself. Shockingly, Jackie did not have any major outbursts until 1950, the time when he was allowed to fight back because the color barrier had already been broken. Finally, in 1950, he fought back and showed the world what other races could do.
Immediately when Jackie broke the color barrier, more and more blacks joined the league. In 1975, the very first team manager joined the majors. His name was Frank Robinson. Frank also opened the doors even more for blacks to have other jobs on a major league team. Jackie Robinson also once refused to move, for he was supposedly a white person on a military bus. He was removed from the army because of that. This made people notice how different people were treated and were starting to change. Jackie Robinson was not just the first black baseball player, but he was also very good. Lots of people look up to him because of that.
Although race relations are not perfect, they have improved a lot since Jackie's time. If Jackie were to be here today, he would think that we have come very far, but we still have problems to solve and goals to reach before we consider our country as equal to all races. Now, professional sports have very high percentages of blacks, including 76.3% players in the NBA and almost 50% of coaches in the NBA. The images of equality in professional sports drives improved levels of equality throughout society. Even though we've improved so much, we still have a very long way to go.
Jackie Robinson was a real follower of Martin Luther King, and they had met a lot of times too. So Jackie Robinson really supported his ideas by being sort of what we would call a mainstream civil rights activist. In other words, he wasn't really a kind of more extreme radical like the Black Panthers, you know, of the 1960s and 70s, but he believed in what King was doing, working with white America, moderates in both the white and minority communities to push for civil rights.
Jackie Robinson inspired many to support and take actions towards making the U.S. a more racially equal country. While he was playing baseball, before he retired, he inspired many people from all around the world to play baseball. People wanted to reach his achievements. Jackie Robinson's life was full of hardship, racism, and prejudice. He changed not only professional baseball forever, but all American sports, and even the country itself. Baseball in America would not be the same if Jackie Robinson never risked everything and went out onto that field.
They had a pat, track and fly. The track and fly ran away, but it came back with a story to say.